when we began with the integration, there was a concern from FC team as well as my colleagues as to whether the management is going to support it or whether the syllabus can support these kind of interventions or modifications to the syllabus. Now that's basically unfounded kind of fear or apprehension, because university on its own gives you certain amount of flexibility. So let's say 10% of the time of your weekly total teaching time is up to the institute to decide. So the institute can really prioritize what they want to focus on and then take the entire college or the institute towards that direction. So that is something which we generally fail to exploit as teachers, as college authorities, administrators also. So that can be drawn upon and really used to our benefit if we really have the will to refocus our teaching learning experience. That is one. And then my experience is that no management would really say no to this. So because it's not something that is, as Vivek would say, negotiable idea, we just have to do it. And my experience has been positive with my college authorities as well as senior teachers, my colleagues as well. So once they get onto the idea, they are more than willing to really carry it through their own delivery, or at least point out that this is a major concern. As far as the syllabus is concerned, perhaps for all the colleges, it would be worth to make this part of the syllabus as well. So one of the changes I have been suggesting to the syllabus makers also is that you look at one studio as a solar passive studio and one studio as an energy studio. So if those two design studios become very emphatically solar passive and energy respectively in maybe second and third year, then that single line in the syllabus can prompt a lot of activity amongst the teachers in their teaching, delivery, session plan making, kind of resources they have to draw upon. So it's kind of forcing teachers to a certain extent, but maybe that is required till it becomes part of our genes. So for example, SPA syllabus, New Delhi, they have a energy studio which is placed in third year. So once the syllabus shouts out, this is energy studio, then a lot of things fall into place. So students are aware, teachers are aware, and even the examiners are aware as to what's going to go into that particular studio. Now one of the disadvantages could be that once the energy studio is done, you don't have to really talk about energy again. But that is something that teachers have to ensure that it doesn't fizzle out or die out with that particular studio, but becomes part of their design ethic or design culture. And again, their final architectural project is something where you can really refocus or recenter the students, whatever project they are taking, whether it's a resort or a multi-storied office or a hotel building. So recenter them and make it part of the questions that are routinely raised, asked and debated in the juries and in the studios. So that should go a long way in really reinforcing this sensitivity amongst the students.